The Lord chose him for himself as high priest, and opening his treasure house, made him rich in all good things. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who in your providence raised up Pope St. Pius V in your church, that the faith might be safeguarded and more fitting worship be offered to you, grant through his intercession that we may participate in your mysteries with lively faith and fruitful charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select among you 7 reputable men filled with spirit and wisdom whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith in the Holy Spirit. Also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenius, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Let your mercy be upon us as we place our trust in you. Lord, let your mercy be upon us as we place our trust in you. Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp. With 10-string lyre, chant his praises. Lord, let your mercy be upon us as we place our trust in you. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all of his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. See, the eyes of the Lord upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When it was evening, the disciples of Jesus went down to the sea, embarked in a boat, and went across the sea to Capernaum. It had already grown dark, and Jesus had not yet come to them. The sea was stirred up because a strong wind was blowing. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the sea and coming near the boat, and they began to be afraid. But he said to them, "It is I. Do not be afraid." They wanted to take him into the boat, but the boat immediately arrived at the shore to which they were heading. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How many of you are familiar with Prochorus or Nicanor, Parmenas? Show of hands. Really, show of hands. These are men that are among the first 7 deacons of the church. And it's almost even for me also like seeing these for the first time and thinking, I never knew Prochorus. Who is he? Never heard that name before. We have. I think it gives us a beautiful reminder that the notoriety of name, to be known in our generation or for the generations to come, is not one of the treasures in heaven. So often we may long for that, but it's not one of the great gifts that God gives us. But to serve our Lord, to fulfill the need in his time and the time that we live in, for these men to have served at the table and to be that response, that responsiveness, to simply have been a deacon called forth by one of the apostles was a great treasure. You may think of all of those men and women. We never know their name. We don't need to have books that go out to all of the ends of even this nation or this country. But the circle of people that our God has put around us, do we serve them well? Do we serve his word well in this moment? Today reminds us that's the treasure. With hearts that long to be united with our Heavenly Father and receive his great gifts, we bring all of our prayers and petitions to his heavenly throne. For Pope Francis and for all the bishops throughout the world, that they be given the entirety of the Holy Spirit and all of the gifts needed to profess and proclaim the holy gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who serve our communities in anonymity and quiet silence, that they be rewarded in heaven for the gifts and the love that they have provided in this life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the deacons of the church throughout the world, that they be given the strength and endurance to complete all the work that our God has asked of them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are poor and suffering and whose needs are going unmet, that there are those around them who are called to provide for what they need, especially in ways of health care, of food, of shelter, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who die this day, especially those who give their life in defense of the life of another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention of this Holy Mass, for the eternal rest of Joan Keening Martz, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dearest Father, you have called forth your sons and daughters, each according to your will and plan, to bring forth the holy gospel throughout the world. Look kindly upon us and generously support us in the mission that you have given to us, that we may bring light and salvation to the world as you have commanded, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honor of Blessed Pius V, a means of our eternal salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy. Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new an eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, save us.
Blessed Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The Good Shepherd has laid down his life for his sheep. Alleluia. Let us pray. May the sacraments we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which blessed Pope Pius V burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.